Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, I'm going to show you how to drive a 5V relay or 12V relay using Arduino and simple transistor, one resistor, and one diode to turn on and off or control an AC or DC load like this. This is now a DC load. You will get the code for this by clicking at the link which is below the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. In many applications, you need to turn on and off an AC or DC load, and you need to be able to handle higher current. For that reason, you will need to use relay. These relays are very cheap, should be available. You just need to have a transistor, a resistor, and a diode for protection of this relay, so you will be able to send signal and turn this on and off. And using this one, you can turn on and off your load, which could be AC or DC. These are the components that you need. This is 2N3904 NPN transistor. This is 1 kilo ohm resistor. This is a diode. The top of the relay and between the VCC and this side that is connected to the collector of the transistor, you put a diode. The job of this diode is when the relay turns off, the energy that is released or kickback voltage will be absorbed by this relay, and it protects this transistor. And this transistor is acting as a switch. When the signal comes, it connects the collector to emitter. It becomes a short circuit. Approximately, that's ideally a short circuit, and VCC is on the other side, ground is on this side. The relay will energize and this contact will go down, meaning this line and these two wires, the connection will be established and your load will be connected. The transistor has three pins. This is called collector with a no sign or nothing, and this sign we have arrow. This is emitter, the arrow is outside. This is NPN or negative type transistor, and this is base, which is shown as B. And here are the, when you hold the transistor, these are the emitter, base, collector from left side, and the transistor is 1 kilo ohm. The diode has a line here. This side is called anode and this side is called cathode, and the cathode is has a line. And if you are using 1N4148, this diode also has a black line, so that is cathode and this is anode. Part of the time you need the load to be turned on when it's energized, so you will be connecting it on this side. So normally open, these two pins are called normally open, this is normally closed. Now I have here 5V in this power supply. The relay doesn't have a polarity, so if I connect it here, you can hear a click. Doesn't matter if I change the polarity because it's just a winding. And these are the two pin of the multimeter when you connect it. Continuity tester with both. Disconnect. And it buzzes. So to show you these connections, these two are normally connected. Now they are connected. If I power this up, the relay energized, the load is disconnected. Connected, disconnected. Now let's go to the other one. Do not change that one. If you connect it here, the load is not connected, the switch is off. And now when I energize it, so we will be connecting it there. Now the diode, which is this diode, anode and cathode, we will be connecting it between these two pins. To make it simple, I'm gonna put it here so we will reduce the usage of extra wires anode. Here I've prepared the relay. I put a diode here. The anode is on this side, the cathode is on this side, which is a positive. I put the red wire, and this is the black wire. These two are, I put a header for connection, and the middle wire also I put here between the positive. From positive, this goes to anode, and cathode goes to the negative, so the LED will turn on, and these two wires will be connected to the load, whatever load I want to turn on, AC or DC. I have here 5 volts now. When I connect the relay to 5 volts, it goes on and off. And here is how you connect your load. This is the load, and it needs two wires to be connected to power. This doesn't matter if it's AC or DC, so the two wires are coming to the load, and the circuit completes like that. Now, to control it with the relay, we just cut here or do something like this. The power goes to relay. Relay needs two wires. When it switches it, it connects this wire back here, and the load will turn on. So these two extra wires will be created. If you just cut here, it will be two wires. This is the 3904 transistor, as you can read it. And on this side, this is emitter, base, collector, according to this. So emitter, base, collector. Emitter goes to the ground. I'm gonna put one wire here for emitter. This is emitter, and this side will go to the ground of this Arduino. I'm gonna control the base. I put 1 kilo ohm resistor, and then this one will be connected to the pin 2. I'm gonna use pin 2. So here, this is a base. As we said, the middle pin is base. We have 1 kilo ohm resistor here, and from the resistor I'm gonna put one wire to pin 2. This will be connected to pin 2. These are my two wires, the black and red, for the relay, which is a positive. I put the red wire. This side goes to the positive. I'm gonna connect it to 5 volts of Arduino. And the negative on this side, I labeled it as negative. This will go to the collector of transistor. I'm gonna go here, and the collector of transistor is the last pin here. So this is the last pin, and that is the collector. Now this is done, the circuit is ready. And now these two wires are the load wire, so we will connect it. Now let me explain the code. We are defining a pin for relay. So this, in this case, it's pin 2. So we call it relay pin. Now from now on, I'm going to use this word instead of number 2. So it will not be confusing in case if you're using different pins for different purpose. And then this is a setup which will run only once. Inside this pin setup, we say pin mode and relay pin, which is pin 2, as an output. Also, we define pin 2 to be able to send signal out. And then we initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud. This is the monitor. If I click here, it shows this serial monitor. And at the bottom on the right side, you see here this number 9600 must match this number in order to print the information for you. And then I print this Robojax.com relay module. And inside the loop, we say digital write pin 2 to be high. This will turn on the relay for us. And then we print this one on the screen. So let me upload it. So this is when a program runs, it says relay on, and then wait for 5 seconds, and then send a low signal to pin 2 with the digital write. So this will turn off the relay, print this text, relay off, and wait for 3 seconds, and it continues like that. Relay on, off, on, off, on. It starts from on at the beginning. If your application needs the relay to be off or on, at the beginning, before doing anything, just one of these lines should be here. And then you can set the relay to be either high or low. And also if your application needs, so the program or relay doesn't start after a few seconds, let's say a machine or something speeds up, so you can add here a delay, let's say 2 seconds. Until this is not finished, the loop will not start. So this will give your other devices to boot up if you need it. Now let me demonstrate it. Now I'm connecting this base to pin 2. And let me turn this on. When I run this, it shows on. And the light is on and it's off. It prints the text. And also we have a status LED here which tells us that the relay is on. And the load is also on. You can change the wait time here. For example, you can make it 300 milliseconds and then 1 second. This will cause the relay to turn on very small moment and then off. Now this is a new signal. That's it. Thanks for watching. This was how to drive a relay using Arduino with simple transistor. If you learned and like this video, please thumb up and also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.